Sri Lanka is facing an unprecedented economic crisis. The country's foreign exchange reserves have dropped sharply, meaning they'll struggle to pay for imports in the coming months. The BBC's Ambarasanathirajan reports from the capital, Colombo.
Neluka Dilrukshi is adjusting to the new reality. Until recently, she was using a cooking gas cylinder to prepare food for her four children. But now, firewood is her only option. Her husband is a day-wage labourer. With the rising cost of essential items, they are struggling to make ends meet.
Cooking gas cylinder prices have almost doubled, and we cannot afford it anymore. I used to provide fish and vegetables daily to my children. Now we are giving them one vegetable with rice. Earlier, we used to have three meals a day. Now we can afford only two. We can't spend all the money on food, as we have to spend on their education as well.
The increasing food prices are hitting the families hard, particularly lower income group families. And the prices have gone up to 30% for some items in this year. With the government facing more problems in the foreign exchange reserves, the prices of certain food commodities are likely to go up further.
The crisis is unprecedented. Sri Lanka has banned the import of several items, following a sharp decline in foreign exchange reserves and falling revenues. The pandemic has made matters worse for tourism, the mainstay of Sri Lanka's economy. As a result, millions of Sri Lankans have been stretched to their limits.
Sri Lankans are quite sensitive to food price inflation. There has been already a lot of negative sentiment regarding the constraints that we are seeing. And I think it is probably quite close to a point where there is a lack of further tolerance of this level of price escalation on food prices in particular.
Sri Lanka has been borrowing heavily to boost its economy and infrastructure over the years, especially after the end of the civil war in 2009. Now, it faces the prospect of a loan default for the first time since independence from Britain in 1948.
We had to go into a restriction of imports because the pressure on our current account as well as on our trade deficit was increasing due to the pandemic situation. But as a responsible government, we need to manage it. One thing, we have to make the stuff available and then make it available at an affordable price.
The government has dispatched its ministers to several capitals desperately seeking loans. But the move is seen as a firefighting exercise than going for the root cause. With further import restrictions on the cards, for people like Neluka, it will be a challenge to keep the firewood in their kitchen going. Ambarasanathirajan, BBC News, Colombo.